Okay, boom, viewers, welcome back to the channel. Subscribers, you already know the thing set. We're blessed. Hope you're having a wonderful day today. But you know my style. One bag of bag, you know, I gotta continue getting them daily updates on the people you see and don't see on the screen. That's why it's extremely important to watch it and so you don't miss a thing. And with that being said, let's just kick it off with some good news from dancer Princess Shenseea.
So we made it to London. And look where I'm staying, right beside the O2 Arena. I'll be setting out this arena in the next couple of years, God's willing. And then we move on to the stadiums. It's a long-term thing, honey. It's a journey.
And who says dream doesn't come true? And I mean, sometimes you gotta speak it out there and put it in the universe for it to manifest. You see, my sir, as you know, Shenseea, you know, been in the game for like 5-6 years. You see, my sir, I know she's finally achieving what she set out to do. You see, my sir, so she can check that off of the bucket list. I'm putting out a comment section how much people the O2 Arena, U2 Arena hold. You see, my sir, you know, she's that pan world tour in England and thing. You see, my sir. And you know, she was shelling it down and all of this stuff and inviting fans on stage for sing her song and thing. But that's not giving them an update that, you know, dreams do come true. Well, speaking about dreams come true, we know Vybz Kartel and his co-accused how dreams have become a reality. They're once again no longer, you know, considered a convicted criminal or murderer in the eyes of the law, which is upsetting citizens of Jamaica because they don't understand the law to begin with. You know what I mean? They're co-signing the DPP violating constitutional rights, which ain't right, and upset with the law lord's decision to overturn that victory. You know what I mean? And you know, with the amendment retrial business, there ain't gonna be one, so she lost, you feel me? But a lot of people is speaking out, so let's hear what this lady is saying, and then we'll proceed.
Paul, you see everybody have them 2 cents to say, look at me, I'm a black woman just like you. Turn around and look, do you have any kids? Leave Kartel alone, it's about time. Leave the man alone. Paul Lewin, be careful the car where you're driving a flip. Because we can use spirituality and tie the steering and make the four wheel. No moving, you know, and big truck come and crush your Paul Lewin. Spiritually, look me good. My name Teach and Preach. I live in Canada. Listen me, dirty girl, dirty woman, can a woman stand a case it's to all the child she bear? Listen, it's about time for you step off a Vybz Kartel, Paul Lewin. You need to burn in a black candle, man, in a graveyard. Black candle with your name the panny 7 times and burn you in a every graveyard of Kingston and see if you don't get fucked.
Put in the comment section if you agree with the lady or not. Like I said, people, my stance on this Vybz Kartel situation is he hasn't been given a fair trial. And when someone's constitutional rights is violated, it can be any one of us because the Constitution is for all of us. And when we have DPP people committing, I don't want to say perjury, but violating the Constitution to get guilty verdicts, it's not a good look. You know, I mean, her integrity is questionable now. You see, man, I said, all of her other cases that she convicted, you know, poor ghetto people, has been compromised. As well as all of the cases that she, you know, let these rich, uptown people walk away free. You see, man, I said, this is why the law can't be taking the law into their own hands. I'm breaking it to be getting a guilty verdict. You see, man, I said, it's a waste of taxpayers' money. You see, man, I said, no, she lose a trophy prize and has been exposed. But anyway, people, let's proceed to the next thing that's, I think, concerning the DPP. If she tried a case, yeah, with, you know, Dana Lee and Noel, you feel me? Dana Lee's mother, you know, found a birthday card that Noel gave, you know, her daughter 2 days, you know, before her disappearance. You see me, I said, she had this to say, a beautiful day to y'all. I was going through my baby girl things When I saw this birthday card Noelle gave Donna 2 days before her disappearance, how can people act this cool and wicked? So people, read the words he wrote in that card to my daughter about she being his strength and backbone. And Noelle is the only man left standing to tell me what happened to my daughter, really, but refused to do so. How you do it, Jankro? Me tired, my energy is drained right now. It is just a hard pill to swallow. So let's take a look at this birthday card. I know you can press pause and read it for yourself because you know my reading. Yeah. Let's proceed to the next. Enough of the hype is responding to Tulux and Jay Frost. I guess somebody wanted to interview him, you know, surrounding this body wash business. That the man them like, you know what I mean? I don't know which one is asking him to do an interview because I don't really watch these people. You see me? But Footy said he has no interest on sitting on a doo-doo clout coach. You see me? So let's take a listen to what he has to say and then we proceed.
Come and tell me nothing. I ask me nothing about what I see. Zine, when you go under the, if you have a problem with something, you no go under where you see the problem and go complain. You no stop foot and talk phone, you know. Me a talk on behalf of myself. So when you no see nothing where bother, you no come tell me. Worst me never see me, never did me no know what go on. You no leave me all tight, Bridget. You understand? You no leave me all tight and deal with it on yourself. Get me? Yes, so Uno leave me out of it, man. You see, if Uno, the followers and the fans them, start go under the page them and make the people them know how Uno feel, it will not look like, cause first thing you got here, foot a bad mind, foot a red eye, foot a chat too much, foot a this, foot a that. When Uno me really a try to save, so me not try to save Uno no more, don't come over here, so with nobody problem. You understand? When you go over there, go comment and make on a nice. As me wait this morning, me see more than about 15 messages on my DM. If me see where Rebel do. If I that dance I'll go on to, don't ask me. Go over there and ask where you see it. Then go over where you see it. Go ask. Me not see it. Me never know nothing about that. Don't ask me. Yeah. That's what me think there now. Big man thing. That's what me think there. If you don't see nothing shaky over here, so, and you don't see foot do nothing shaky, leave me alone. Zin, leave me the fuck alone. Cause when me address things, I only see a man, I jump on a hopscotch over here, so I agree with me. Go over there, so I cuss about me chat too much. Go over there, so foot out about the police, foot out this, foot out that. Come in and know me if you're a different straightness and a man I got call me. Batty police. That means you agree. We dey do the business. You understand? So me no want argue them people. Eh? Any man where you hear a burn out footer hype for defense straightness, they ain't have to be do the man. Like a next man, people, remember you know, if me see somebody stepping a shit, and am my job to clean it? Am my job to clean it? No. Me not clean nobody shit. Some of the man them are stepping a shit and then I cover it up and I act like say people not gonna smell it. People are gonna smell it. So when you do your wrongs now and the whole world will beat you till you turn off comment and you're afraid to hear the voice of the people. Them. Turning off your comment mean you're guilty, you know, brother. Means so you know what you do. So our footer hype name now become the reasoning point. After you shit up yourself, me no business with you, no. Me just not deal with you, no. Me take on myself. So, oh, now the arguing point is footer. Oh, footer hype is the arguing point when me not trouble nobody. All me say me I do, I take on myself. Me no want to be no friend with you, no. If you want to go over doodle land, me no want to see you, no. So, a man a drown in a shit and I call my name. If you save me, me can't save you, brother. Yeah, you can't, no, me can't save you. Remember, you know, When you do what you do, you know, you can't nobody do what you did do, you know. You know, remember that part there? Remember, you know, when you do what you do, you can't nobody do what you did do, you know. So, oh, foot a name, Japan. No man never called me when they do it and say, Jano, you know, say, me think it's a good idea to interview Dodo Boy. I make me say, nah, No matter what you got to talk about, the interview did not go work. Cause you and Dodo Boy not supposed to conversate in the first place for line up appointment, for set up interview, fix up your house and fix up your studio, if you invite Dodo Boy in as a guest, if you Dodo Boy sit down and reason with you? No. You can turn on your life by yourself and rub out Dodo Boy by yourself. You don't need a conversation with Dodo Boy. Right now, anybody interview Dodo Boy can interview RuPaul, you can interview Shibata, you can interview anybody. You don't have nothing against Dodo people. You understand? So, all foot a job here. Me no have nothing to do with it. You notice me no come cuss and call nobody name and real. Me no business. Me over straight world and me I do my thing. Me no business with nobody. Me just know say me cut off anybody where interview Dodo Boy or make Dodo Boy interview them. If you go up on the Dodo coach, you can't tell me nothing. Just stay over there. Nobody deal with me. You understand me, I say? When you not understand, me and nobody can go at it. Cause which part them, they mean of them, they are Dodo land. Me of a straight nation, me and them cannot go at it. Me not try trace with nobody. Me, and this is not a tracing match, you know. This is a decision making thing. You have to know when to draw the line. Now, obviously, some man a look Dodo clout. Cause there's no way me can want interview no Dodo man for no reason. Me no need to talk to you. Me no need to. First thing, I no buck ups. Me no do the man, I do what them I do. Them know what them I do, and them decide to do it. So, me no want nobody to tell me, say, Ray, me and nobody no in an argument. Me just make a decision, say, me, I cut off anybody we deal with over Dodo land and carry a career go put over Dodo land. Why would I want to have my good straight career now and go interview a Dodo man and put my career in a Dodo man bottom? No. Me no want to interview you, me no want to talk to you, me no want to party you, me no want to hear what your office say. If you say what you did say, you can't, nobody say what you did say. So, me no need to hear nothing more. You understand what me I say? Yeah, so me over yourself a straight nation, me no want nobody say nothing to me, but me no have to call no name. Anybody, listen to the word, anybody go take an interview from Dodo man, sit down on the Dodo coach, avoid me. Then, any man will invite Dodo man on them program and interview Dodo man, me now want to see you. When you're not on a limit, when you're not on a limited, when you will do anything for clout, not trust you. Know. Anybody you see do that, me not trust them. Dodo clout, you know, look. There's nothing where Dodo man could have do. I say, if you make me want to interview me, interview your mother. So, I did some thing there. Who over here, sir? Stay over here, sir. Who over there, sir? Stay over there, sir. I'm not chasing with nobody. I'm not arguing with nobody. I'm not back and forth with nobody. Make my decision, and I stand by it. I don't want to see you now. I don't want to heal me. I don't want to. Them just call my name because my name are the name with the power. Yeah, me are the powerhouse. So then Africa call my name. So when they not call me, say them I call my name, I laugh, cause it not have nothing to do with me. Me can't help them, you know. Them are drawn in on them own shit, you know. And me do nothing for make them a face pressure with them a face. And them do it. And them know what they made I do before them do it. But them I think one way, them I think say, yeah man, we are taking clout, man. Very. And the clout turning now on big toilet. And toilet you can't flush. So me over here, so I do what me I do same way. Me just cut off people. Just done with people. You understand me, I say? Straight. Yeah, so what else is happening in Jamaica? What's going on in Jamaica? I haven't been to Jamaica in 5 years. What's going on down there? What's going on in Jamaica? I see the ghetto parties flapping out and all the uptown parties are ram. What is going on? Me see all of the ghetto party them. I struggle to have people. And all the uptown party them black. How are you going? How are you going, Ven? How are you going? I want to cuss about. Me no know if you don't see the shift where I'm going, you know.
Hey, put in the comment section what you think about that. No, he's going to touch bases on this uptown versus ghetto dancehall business. You see what I say? Because he's quite upset that, you know, Young Miami and the uptown crew get, you know, a big turnout. You see what I say? And when ghetto people kick them things, it empty. You know what I mean? So let's take a listen to what he has to say and then we'll proceed.
I don't know if you want to see where I go on, but even in a foreign, when the ghetto people them keep dance, it empty. Ghetto man them got a party, beg for Balong people price. Them want 15 and 20 ticket. Then, when the uptown event them keep offering, the same man will beg ticket go the ghetto party them, go at the next party them and buy 10, 20 ticket at $80 one, or $100 one. Now me see, the ghetto people them buy plane ticket, pay hotel fee, rent car, everything, plus pay going at the event them, plus buy champagne, plus the everything and it not bother them. But when the ghetto man keep something, them itch up out of the gate, if you not give them free ticket, them walk and tell everybody not go your party. Cause, you know, give them no free ticket. But when them a go the people and where them don't know a party, them go and pay. You understand what me I say? Some realize see, our new type of slavery are gone. The people them are enslaved themselves because them are, when me look at my granny used to say, don't pay dear for going to a high company. And at that me see all I get to people them I do now. Them want to go these uptown party and act like they're rich. But when them a go them bridging party, all them friend them no want to pay. So you support the stranger and tear down your friend. Okay. That's why you see me appreciate every promoter will book me. Every little promoter will book me. You know them little corner. And you know them little area. And you know them little zone. Me love on you. And me respect on you. You know why? It's not easy. With the corruption we are going. And the bad mind, and the something them, it not easy, because ghetto people, bad mind. Why you no want to pay $20 or $30 going to your friend party? Why you call a friend and beg him ticket for $30, but you pay $80 and $100 plus buy plane ticket plus pay Airbnb plus rent car? Figure somebody where you don't know a party. Plus, Gamal go spend nearly $5,000-$6,000. Pan clothes. And then you tell your friend, say, rate your friend. Yeah, watch you know. Yeah, watch you know, wicked. You know, wicked. But, I saw life set up, man. And we have to know ourselves, you know. But some people just not gonna know themselves until they're back against the wall. You get me? So me, I appreciate every little promoter.
Yeah, put in the comment section what you think about that. Like I said, people, you know, these promoters, they're just gonna have to start playing ball with the law. You feel me? And apply for them permits if they can afford it or if they can even obtain it. Because, you know, racism and prejudice and classism is all hand in hand. You know what I mean? But the dancehall reggae scene has been infiltrated the Uptown guys is gonna make all the money off of it. You know, and you know, ghetto people is gonna have to, you know, find a new way out. You see me? I said, like how, you know, ganja and reggae and dancehall was providing for them. You see me? And I mean, I'm putting in the comment section waiting about them. Anyway, people, man, no longer, you know, don't forget to like, share, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell to be notified whenever I drop the latest. Bless.